Hi guys, guess what? Today I'm gonna go see Mother, which I'm so excited about. I'm not a huge Jennifer Lawrence fan, but I was just drawn in by the trailer, I'm gonna be real with you. I think that the trailer gave away a lot, so even watching it, I was a little bit like, fuck, I feel like it's just showing so many aspects of the film and so many twists and turns, but I'm okay. Sorry, there was a little something on there. But I'm okay with that because I haven't really looked into it otherwise. I actually worked late last night, so I finished earlier today, which is great because I can go see a 4 p.m. showing. Today is actually the first day it comes out here, so I'll go see the 4 p.m. showing and there won't be many people there. I don't think that this is a very hyped movie here. Even when I went and saw It on the day it had its public release, there wasn't much people in the cinema. So, I mean, there was a lot of people in the cinema, I shouldn't say that. It just wasn't full. So I'm not too worried. It'll be a good crowd, I think. And it's also not a movie that I think a lot of teens are gonna go see, so I'm not too worried about that. It should be a good showing and I'm really excited. So let's go see Mother. I just finished watching Mother. I knew it went for 2 hours, but those are two of the longest hours of my life. The movie, I would like to explain what it's about. I didn't realize it was gonna be as art house as it was. It was very different to what I assumed. And it was so funny that I thought that the trailer was gonna give away anything, because it is impossible to give away anything to do with this movie. Can't tell you why. Originality factor, I can tell you, is 10 out of 10 already. This film is just full of symbolism and it really spoke to me in a very sad way, but it could obviously, because it's so symbolic, and there is parts sprinkled in, which pretty much says that the film is meant to mean what it means to you. It's very obvious, the symbolism of that, but it is about a couple. One is like a poet, and the other one's Jennifer Lawrence. She's quite a mousy chick. I bet you she has no name as well. I need to double check this. Yeah, Jennifer Lawrence's name, yep. No one has a name. Okay, I didn't even realize that. I knew that she definitely didn't have a name. Okay, so that is how fucking art house it gets, and it's that way for a reason, because it's meant to be symbolic to you and your situation. But she is in this house and she's fixing it up with her husband, partner, whatever. He is a poet and he can't write, and then strange people start showing up in their house. It is shot in such an amazing way because it's all very up close, like elongated shots where it's kind of like not one takes, but you're like right behind her. She's walking through the house and the house is amazing, and it's like a maze and it makes you feel really claustrophobic, and if you have anxiety, prepare to be anxious. This movie, I feel like, definitely simulates a lot of anxiety that people have, especially social anxiety. There was a lot going on all of the time and it really does not give you space to breathe. In saying that, I did think it was a little bit too long. I don't want to explain the epic that is this film, but it goes onto these epic long scenes that just keep dragging on and on and on and on for like 40 minutes, and it's a lot. I would say that this movie has the best arc, story arc, or the most amazingly weird story arc I've ever seen in a film, because it's, you think it's like about to end and then it just gets even stranger, which I was not expecting. When it was strange, I was like, whoa, this is intense, but then it just got so intense. I think that this film really does speak to a lot of women who feel, I don't know, it's definitely a relationship movie, and it's definitely for women who feel like they're in the back burner. But as I said, it can probably mean a lot of things to a lot of people. I think Jennifer Lawrence was amazing in this film, and like I said before, I'm actually not a fan of her, so she was incredible and she made you forget that she was even Jennifer Lawrence, which I really liked. But Michelle Pfeiffer was the other standout for me. I think that her character was awful, but also like so believable. This film makes you feel all of the emotions. It is gory. It is gory as fuck, actually. It's pretty crazy that I just saw this in a mainstream cinema as well, because it doesn't make any sense to me. The violence that are in this movie, I hope it was R, because it was really, really intense. I know I'm spewing a lot of different emotions at you right now, because I feel a lot of different ways about this movie. This movie was incredible very fantasy fiction and then really realistic at the same time. It has this really nice juxtapose between being complete fantasy, and I'm talking about fantasy with like animation and kind of mixed media in a sense, and then it just is so realistic, emulating like emotions that people have and anxieties that people go through, and you really feel for Jennifer Lawrence's character. You just want to shake everyone and tell them to fucking get their act together, but you can't, and it can be a frustrating movie at times, but also just so intriguing. It isn't a surprise when you look at the director of this film, who did Requiem for a Dream and Black Swan. I am a huge fan of Requiem for a Dream. It's one of the first really disturbing films I ever saw, and it will definitely be up there for the rest of my life. And Black Swan is also probably my top 20, 30, 40, I don't know, but it's in my top films. I love that movie. So it definitely has that Black Swan element where you just, is this real, is this not? But I think it's just a very symbolic film that it really breaks through and touches you in a certain way. And I guess that is always his aim. You look at Requiem for a Dream, it has that same kind of in and out aspect of, is this happening, is this reality, is it not? So if you like that, I'm sure you'll be into it. If you want a clear cut movie, this is not the film for you at all. But if you're really interested in getting absorbed in the film, and I really recommend going seeing it in the cinema, because it was a lot. I don't even know how I would watch this at home. This film you cannot watch at home, I don't think. So I know it is going crazy right now. So if you want to see a film that isn't probably getting as much love, check out Mother. What the fuck just happened to my life? I love it. I love it. But as I said, there were some points where I'm like, come on, let's just move it along. I'm going to give this film a 7 out of 10 for personal. I'm going to give it a scare score of maybe a 6 for the graphic content. I don't think it's very scary, but it is very graphic. And originality, like I said before, I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10. Have you guys seen Mother? What an amazing film. If you haven't, check it out. If you have, let me know what you thought in the comments. And let me know what it meant to you, because I have a feeling this film is going to mean a lot of different things to a lot of different people. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a great day, and I'll talk to you very soon. Stay spooky, guys.